and welcome to day number 18 of our Christmas Advent Yoga. So today we are going to be doing a little flow that is about centering yourself. So becoming balanced and also just having that feeling of being grounded as well. We will be using our core and to really try and maintain our balance, but we'll also maybe need a block, not a strap, but just potentially a block. So you may want to pause the video, go and find whatever it is you may need. And we are then going to come onto our mat, sitting up nice and tall as always, relaxing the mind and the breath, and just begin to close the eyes. So arriving on your mat with the legs crossed, spine nice and tall, lengthening through the back, releasing tension on every exhale. Centering yourself here, weight evenly distributed between both sitting bones, chin parallel to the floor and hands just gently resting onto the knees. Focusing on your breath and becoming aware of any space and also any tension that you may be holding within the body. Letting the breath be smooth and even. And as you begin to reach the arms up towards the sky, take a deep breath in, bring the palms together. Lifting above the head and slowly bring them down to heart center. Begin to interlace your fingers, turn the palms away, stretching through the fingers. Still lifting up through the crown of the head and ensuring that you're not rounding the spine. We lift the arms up above the head, taking a deep breath in. And exhale, slowly release, now dropping your right ear to right shoulder. So you should be feeling a stretch down the left side of the neck, ensuring that the right ear is staying down, not coming, the shoulder's not coming up to the ear. We lift the arms up and we exhale, bring the hands to heart center. Ready to go again on the other side. Stretching through the palms, again keeping the spine nice and tall. Lengthen through the back, lift the arms above the head. Inhale, stretch, and exhale, lower the hands, fingertips touching the earth, dropping the left ear to left shoulder. Inhale, lifting the arms back up. Exhale, bring them through to heart center. So you bring the knees up, coming up onto all fours, ensuring that again wrists are underneath your shoulders so that you have a firm base, knees underneath hips. You're going to start to extend the left leg behind you and begin to lift the leg up. Try and keep the hips as centered as possible. And we lower the leg down, lifting up the right leg. Lowering back down, making sure you've got nothing behind you to kick. And then we go with the left side again. And the right. And as we're lifting the leg up, we're making sure the weight is still distributed evenly between the hands. We start to lift the opposite arm and opposite leg, keeping the movement going. Trying not to twist too much through the hips. Engaging the core. And then just gently twisting side to side, working through cat and cow perhaps as well. And just shifting the weight forwards and back. Take the arms forwards, drop the hips down and lower the chest all the way down to the earth. Gazing forwards, tops of the feet gently pressing into the ground. Lift the chest up to your cobra. Exhale, begin to take the glutes all the way back into your child's pose. Arms are lengthened out in front, gazing forwards, bringing the weight forward slightly, and exhale, release back to your downward facing dog. First of all, keeping the heels off the ground. And then gently ease the left heel down and hold for a couple of breaths, and then go the same with the right. the legs, knee down the back of the leg on one side, and going again on the other. Begin bend and straightening the knees at the same time. Pushing through the hands, keeping that spine nice and long. Shifting the weight forwards into your plank, holding for a couple of breaths. Exhale, push back. And then we go again, inhale, coming forwards. Exhale, push back. Lift the right leg up. Begin to draw the knee in. Gaze forwards and step the foot in between the hands. Lengthening through the back, we begin to drop the back heel, open up the arms into Warrior Two. Reaching forwards, length of the torso, the palm turns over. Exhale, reverse all the way back. And then coming into your side angle stretch. Lengthen the arms, straighten the front leg. Reach forwards, tilt at the hips, Trikonasana. Bend that front knee again, arrive back into your Warrior Two. Step forwards and tilt at the hips to come into a half moon. And then bring the arms all the way in, the legs down, slowly roll up. Inhale, stretch. Exhale, bring the hands through to heart center. Grounding through the feet, maybe shifting to the center of your mat. Swing the arms forwards, Utkatasana, chair pose. Lengthen the spine. Ensure knees are together and you can see your toes. Bring the hands to heart center. Coming into a twist, lengthen out the back as you press into the hands. Gaze towards the left shoulder. Inhale, come back to center. And we go over the other way. Doesn't matter if you went the other way before. Just making sure you're looking over your shoulder, arriving back in the center, lifting up, deep breath in. Exhale, hinge forwards, arriving back into Uttanasana. Coming up to your halfway lift, lengthen the spine, gaze forwards. Bring the palms to the earth and step your feet back, arriving in plank. Chaturanga, and then push through to your cobra, or your upward facing dog. Exhale into your downward facing dog, lengthening through the legs, pedaling through. Inhale, stretch up with the right leg. Start to take it out to the side, looking underneath your left arm towards your right foot. Open the hip. Come back to center, draw the right knee in and hover. Exhale, push back. Inhale and draw that knee in. And push back. Bring the right foot down, lengthen up with the left leg, draw the knee in, step the foot through, gazing forwards, Anjaneyasana. Coming into your Warrior Two, check the alignment of the feet, soften into the hips slightly, reach forwards, turn the palm, exhale, reverse. And then taking the arms all the way up and over, lengthen the side of the torso, coming into your side angle. Arriving back in Warrior Two, straighten the front leg. Reach forwards as far as you can, Trikonasana, tilting at the hips. Slowly come back to your Warrior Two. Begin to balance as you bring the weight into the left leg and come into your half moon. Find your balance, and like I am right here. You might find one side much easier than the other. This left side for me today is not happening. Bring the back foot in, slowly rise up, stretching up and bring the hands through to heart center. Again, lifting up, Utkatasana chair pose. Bring the hands back to heart center, crossing left arm to right thigh, lengthen the spine, press into the hands, gaze to the back shoulder. Come back to center, deep breath in and exhale, we twist the other way. Arriving back in the center, we slowly push through the earth, lift the arms up, deep breath in, exhale, hinge forwards. Arriving back in Uttanasana. Lengthen to your halfway lift, plant the hands down, step back. One foot at a time, into plank, engage the core, Chaturanga. Arriving as you rise up to Cobra or Upward Facing Dog, and breathing out, come into Downward Facing Dog. Lifting the left leg, bend the knee, gazing underneath the right arm towards the left foot. Coming into that little twist, draw the knee in, rise up onto the toes of the right foot, shift the weight forward and hover. Send the leg all the way back. And we come again, bringing that foot forwards and the knee in towards the chest. And send the foot back. Plant the foot back down into your downward facing dog. Bend the knees and walk and jump your feet forwards. Swinging the arms forwards slowly and then taking the weight into the right leg. Coming into your warrior three, finding that balance, bringing the hands to the heart center. Or you can fly them back, keep them forwards, whatever feels right. Plant the left foot down, rise up, warrior one. Reaching forwards, planting the hands down. Stepping forward slowly, coming through your half split. And then arrive in Uttanasana. Swing the arms forward slowly and start to shift the weight into the left leg. Lengthen out into warrior three. Hands coming to the heart. Again, engaging that core so you're feeling centered and grounded here. Finding that balance. The back foot comes all the way down. Warrior one, lift the arms up. Taking that deep breath in. Reach forwards, plant the hands down, turn the back to toes and step forwards very slowly through your half split if you want to. Lengthen through the spine, gazing forwards, halfway lift, plant the hands back down. Stepping back into your plank, Chaturanga. Arriving in Cobra or Up Dog. Exhale into Downward Facing Dog. And then slowly start to drop the knees down towards the earth, arriving in your tabletop position. Lengthen the left leg, bring the right hand so it's underneath the shoulder and stretch up with that left arm. You have an option to stay here in your side plank or begin to lift the hips up, arriving with both feet on top of each other. Another option is to lift that left leg, bring the weight round towards the center, and then again, twisting the other way into your side plank. Option to lift the leg if you want to, or you can drop the back knee. Slowly come back to center, dropping both knees, child's pose. Resting here, slowing down the breath. You can bring the palms to meet behind the head if you wish. And take a moment just to again center and ground yourself. You can bring the arms down by your side if you want to. So slowly start to arrive back up. We're just going to have a very quick practice with our balancing today. As our focus is centering yourself. So we're going to do this that we did earlier, arriving into your Utkatasana chair pose. Bring the weight into that right leg and slowly extend the left leg behind you, lengthen out the arms in front, warrior three. You can then start to fly the arms back if you want to. Use your core, focus on a spot so that you are really trying to center yourself here and also ground through that right foot. Place the left leg down. Inhale, lift the arms up. Warrior one. Reach forwards. Lengthen the back. Fingertips touch the earth. The weight comes into that right leg again. And we lift that left leg high. You can use a block here as well if you want to. Does it not have to be full splits? And then come back to center, shaking out the legs. fingertips to the earth again, swing the arms forwards, Utkatasana chair pose. Bring the weight into that left leg, lift the right behind you, extend the leg, flex the foot, reach forwards. Hands again can come to your heart center or you can fly the arms back. Plant that right leg down. Inhale, lift the arms up, warrior one. Left knee is over ankle, reach forwards as far as you can. Plant the hands down to the earth. Shift the weight forwards, lengthen that back leg. Push the heel up towards the sky. Again, you can use a block here if you wish. Slowly bring that foot in to join, arriving in your Uttanasana. And then begin to hug the elbows, just lengthen out the back of the legs. Push through the earth, activate the thighs and stand up to Tadasana. So thank you very much for joining today. I'll look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Namaste. Thank you for joining in today. Don't forget to hit subscribe in order to follow the remainder of our Christmas Advent yoga sessions. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Namaste.